Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Alhamdulillah. This is a great honor for all of us here, for the community of Brentwood Masjid, for the Bay Area, for Northern California, that Alhamdulillah Qazi Saab has visited us, is coming here, Alhamdulillah, to our Masjid. Alhamdulillah, they had programs set for the different Masjids. And I requested the brothers who are coordinating his programs that we would like him to come to our masjid here in Brentwood. And Alhamdulillah, Qazi Saab was very dear and kind that he accepted our invitation. Alhamdulillah, he came to our city and our masjid. And this is truly a great honor and a blessing for us that he is showering us with his blessings and his barakat and his teachings and his knowledge. Alhamdulillah. Inshallah, there is no introduction needed. Qazi Saab himself, inshallah, will speak, and they say in Arabic, "Man dhaqa arafa," the one who tastes will understand what it is. The one who listens will understand who the speaker is and the status and the position of this speaker. However, just a quick small introduction. Qazi Saab is a graduate of Wifaq al-Madaris from Pakistan, where he studied Arabic grammar, Arabic literature, fiqh, jurisprudence, logic, philosophy, ilm al-kalam, seerah, tafsir, hadith, and Islamic history. And in addition to that, he also studied at Peshawar University and Islamic University, Islamabad in Pakistan, where he specialized in law, economics, and political science. And he has taught all these subjects in both in Pakistan and also here in the United States, alhamdulillah, in different institutions and different places. Qazi Saab was also a member of the National Assembly Parliamentarian. He was elected as a National Assembly Parliamentarian in Pakistan, where he worked to provide the underserved areas, to provide jobs, build infrastructure, schools, museums, public health facilities, and increase communication technologies as the chair of the Social Action Board. And he has also traveled extensively throughout the Middle East, North Africa, Europe, Southeast Asia, North and Central America. And Qazi Saab speaks, as we know, multiple languages. He has given lectures and seminars in Arabic, Dari, English, Farsi, Hindi, Pashto, and Urdu. And he has published works in Arabic, Pashto, Urdu, Arabic, and English internationally. And some of his books that are available in English, one of the books is called Jihad, What, Why, When, Where, and How. Very nice book. And another book, it's called Sharia and Politics. Sharia and Politics. And another book is called Science of Hadith. And another book that he has written is Hajj and Umrah According to All Four Schools of Jurisprudence. And another book that he has is called Moonsighting in Islam. So inshallah, without further ado, I'll ask Qazi Saab to please bless us, inshallah, at this time.
Alhamdulillah Nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa nu'minu bihi wa natawakkalu alayhi wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وكريمنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم واكتب لنا في هذه الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة إنا هدنا إليك قال عذابي أصيب به من أشاء ورحمتي وسعت كل شيء فسأكتبها للذين يتقون ويؤتون الزكاة والذين هم بآياتنا يؤمنون الذين يتبعون الرسول النبي الأمي الذي يجدونه مكتوبا عندهم في التوراة والإنجيل يأمرهم بالمعروف وينهاهم عن المنكر ويحل لهم الطيبات ويحرم عليهم الخبائث ويضع عنهم إصرهم والأغلال التي كانت عليهم فالذين آمنوا به وعزروه ونصروه واتبعوا النور الذي أنزل معه أولئك هم المفلحون قل يا أيها الناس إني رسول الله إليكم جميعا الذي له ملك السماوات والأرض لا إله إلا هو يحيي ويميت فآمنوا بالله ورسوله النبي الأمي الذي يؤمن بالله وكلماته واتبعوه لعلكم تهتدون ومن قوم موسى أمة يهدون بالحق وبه يعدلون صدق الله وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم
سيستر زادير شيخ أبو بكر
My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, first of all, I would like to pay thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who gave us this opportunity to get together in a house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to speak for a while regarding deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then I am thankful to you all that you came to the masjid and whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills, for that much time we will be sitting here and we will be trying to understand what our duty is as a Muslim. Respected brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this whole and entire universe, subjugated the whole to the human beings. They have to exploit that for their own good, to the best of their ability and power. Even though there are certain restrictions to its use, so it may not be misused and abused. And on the other hand, As we are utilizing the word of Allah and the creature of Allah, so we have to obey the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well. Because we are named by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as Khalifa. And generation after generation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ خَلَائِفَ فِي الْأَرْضِ لِنَنْظُرَ كَيْفَ تَعْمَلُونَ. Then we made and appointed you as Khalaif, the successors on my earth, because your forefathers, the elders, the generation before you, they passed away. Now we are looking at you and watching you, how you do practice and what you do practice. In a hadith narrated by Imam Tirmidhi, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Ad-dunya hilwa khadira wa inna Allah mustakhlifakum fi aw fiha fayanzura kayfa ta'malun. Ala fattaqu ad-dunya wattaqu an-nisa. Ala wa inna bani adama tawaqatun shatta faminhum man yuladu mu'minan ويحيى مؤمنا ويموت مؤمنا ومنهم من يولد مؤمنا ويحيى مؤمنا ويموت كافرا ومنهم من يولد مؤمن من يولد كافرا ويحيى كافرا ويموت مؤمنا او كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. My dear respected brothers and sisters, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he further elaborated the ayah of Holy Quran, ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ خَلَائِفَ فِي الْأَرْضِ لِنَنْزُرَ كَيْفَ تَعْمَلُونَ, that we are watching you, how you do practice, what you do when you are here in this world. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this dunya, the look and the scene is very beautiful. For beauty, Shaykh Abu Bakr says that we the Arab, we use the word or the term khadira, because khudra and greenery, that is looking very good. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, for its good look, use the word khadira. And its taste is obviously and apparently is very sweet. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, hilwa. Inna dunya hilwatun khadira. Wa inna Allah mustakhlifakum fiha. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made you khulafa here. What the khalifa mean? Now, in certain masjid I was saying there, that khalifa means the ruler, the one who has the authority. So everyone has authority to some extent. And this authority is based upon his intelligence or intellect. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the intellect, so you are using it. And with that intellect or aql and sense, you are utilizing the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is the base of taklif. That's the base of making you bound to obey the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Otherwise, Allah has created the bull, the donkeys, the water buffaloes, the elephant, the horses, the camels, the birds, the eagle, the yaks, the fish, and the shark, and the whale, just name it. But Allah is not addressing them as far as Sharia is concerned. He is addressing us. He says, Ya ayyuhan nas. He is addressing us. He says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina aman. He addresses us, O mankind. He addresses us, O those who believed in the message of Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, why? Because you have the intellect. As you know, that the scientists, and especially those who are expert in anatomy, in physics, yes, like the one who passed away 2-3 days before, Stephen Hawking. So they say that the human brain, animal brain, that has three steps or three stories. So from next side, the first ever story, that is called the brain system. So the natural harakat or movement of your body and different organs that is controlled and being signaled therefrom. You are sleeping, your heart is beating. You are sleeping, your liver is working. You are sleeping, your lungs are working. You are sleeping, your kidney is working. Why? Because the brain system is working when you are sleeping. Yes, will be that when you are awake, the palpitation will be a little bit high. When you are asleep, that will be a little bit low. But still, that's going on. Then, the middle story, or the second story in between, that is called the limbic system. And that limbic system that is controlling or having your feelings and your emotions. And as you know, the animals in general, they have the feelings. Do they have or not?
Yes.
All of you?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. They have feelings.
Yes.
They have emotions or not?
Yes.
They are becoming angry or not?
Yes.
They are becoming sad.
Yes.
They are becoming happy. That is because of the limbic system. Then the upper story or the upper chamber, that is another chamber in animal brain. And we are animal as well, but social. And that sociology is coming there from that upper chamber. Got it? And that upper chamber is the aqal. That is the intelligence. That is the sense of aqal. Yes? For animal, that is empty. But human, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created or put that element there. This aqal. And that is the aqal. There you are controlling the elephant. Yes, that slim guy in the zoo, he is controlling that much big elephant. A slim guy, yes, he is taking a line of 100 camel and they do follow him. Yes, that slim guy, he is riding a horse and he is putting him on run the way he wants. Yes, the slim guy, he is running after a deer and he catch it. The slim guy, he is jumping into the ocean and he is catching the fish. Got it? All that because of that one element which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has put here in the upper chamber. And that's why, if somebody is a foolish guy, yes, and he is speaking a mess, so then we say about him, his upper chamber is empty. We said?
Yes.
Say?
Yes.
We said or not? So that upper chamber, that is your speciality. And because of that upper chamber, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the honor and the respect. وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمُ وَحَمَلْنَاهُمْ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ وَرَزَقْنَاهُمْ مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ وَفَضَّلْنَاهُمْ عَلَى كَثِيرٍ مِمَّنْ خَلَقْنَا تَفْضِيلًا. Brother, you should come forward. No, you should come here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمُ. Indeed, this lamb, Shaykh Abu Bakr says and Shaykh Abdul Basir, that this lamb is called lam-e-taqeed. And after that, qad, that is called harf-e-tahqeeq. So now taqeed and tahqeeq, two engines to the same train. Yes. So it means the engine is very heavy. The cars behind the engine are very heavy, filled up. So that's why Allah put two engines in the front to carry it and to pull it. So what is that car? And what that car is carrying? Karamati Bani Adam. Walakad karramna Bani Adam. From these two letters you can find out what a big honor Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you, O human. And that's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said this is a humiliation to the human. If they are prostrating to a human like them, or even to animal, plant and trees and stones. Why? Because they are the honor. As I told you, that now look, these are grades. There are immovable entities, are having no sense and no life, like the stones, the mountains. Then, after that, there are the sense, are the growing entities like the plant and the trees. They have a sensor to some extent. There are certain plants, if you will touch it, so it falls down. Because of what?
Sense.
Because of sense. There is one plant that called, touch me not. That called?
Touch me not. The moment you will touch it, it goes down. Got it? So they have sense. They have, even there are some plants in different areas on the hilltops. If an animal having blood is passing by, the plant grab him and suck its blood. Sense. Got it? Then, after that, the third category, that is of movable entities. Yes, they have the sense. They have the life. They move the birds, the animals, the sea world. They have the, and then after that, the highest category and quality is that of you. The humans. You are white or you are black. You are gray or you are brown. You are tall or you are short. You are rich or you are poor. You are dressed or you are naked. Still, you are a human. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this human. وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
I'm a student of philosophy. So I don't think that I'm flying too high. You can catch me. Yeah. You are a good glider. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ. Indeed. Surely, for sure, verily, we have honored the human being, the children of Adam. How? وَلَكَدَ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمْ وَحَمَلْنَاهُمْ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ. What is hamal? If you are putting something over the other, that's called hamal. Loading, lodging with, putting it upon. وَحَمَلْنَاهُمْ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I have given them the controlling hand on the ocean and on the land as well. And when Allah says land, so land doesn't mean that here the ground, which is full of dust, it goes up to this heaven. So the space, that's in your control in one way or the other. That's why you are getting the solar energy therefrom, and you are giving light to the whole streets. وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمْ وَحَمَلْنَاهُمْ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحَرِ. So now look, when Allah has given you that much big honor, that's for free. There is no free lunch in America. Is there any?
No.
There is no free lunch. So all these are for free. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ هِيَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا خَالِصَةً يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, all these things there in the word of Allah, that is being created basically for those who believe in Allah in the proper way. Got it? But the non-Muslim, they are exploiting because of them. Like, you have a respectable guest of yours. Yes, you are living somewhere in a far-flung area in a village where there is no electricity. The weather is hot. You have a hand fan. Yes, and you are serving your guest. Yes, but somebody, he is sitting beside him to his left or to his right. He is getting the air or not?
Yes.
Say, because of whom? The moment the guest will stand up, you will stop the pain. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, basically, I have created all these things for those who have iman. But the others, they are exploiting it because of them. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, now on the day of judgment, or in the akhirah, all these beautiful things will be only for the believers, not for the disbelievers. Here, they are exploiting it because of you. But there, you are the only owner. You are the only user. You will have it. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَحِيمًا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Rahim, merciful for the believers. Otherwise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has two attributes, Rahman and Ar-Rahim. And both are derived from the word Rahmah. Its istiqaq is from the word Rahmah. And Rahmah means mercy. Now, what's the formation of Rahman and Rahim? Both are sigata al-mubalagha. Elative adjectives. Elative adjectives. Yeah. Now, elative adjectives. Rahman means the most merciful. Rahim means the most merciful. But thanks to Sayyidina Ali, radiyallahu ta'ala an, he was sitting in masjid. He was saying, Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim. We do say the same. Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim. Then he said, Ya Rahman al-Dunya, wa Ya Rahim al-Akhirah. O the Rahman of this world, O the Rahim of the hereafter. What it means? That here, the Rahmah and the mercy you have, O Allah, that is inclusive in general. It includes everyone. Even it includes Pharaoh. It included Abu Jahl. It included those who do not believe in Allah and they are atheistic one. Are those who are challenging the authority of Allah, they are eating?
Yes.
Yes. They are drinking?
Yes.
No. They are taking oxygen?
Yes.
They are exploiting the word of Allah? Yes. Because Allah is Rahman. Ya Rahman al-Dunya, wa ya Rahim al-Akhirah. So now Rahim, that Rahmah and mercy, that is special and perfect. So here the general and the inclusive one, that is for creature in general. There the specific one, that is special for those who believed in Allah subhanahu. Say Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah.
Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, don't take it easy. You are good guys. When Allah blessed you with Iman and you said La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, a delegation of Banu Tamim came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ila ma tad'u ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is your message? What you are calling towards? What you are inviting people towards? Why the people have become enemy to you? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had enemies?
Yes.
Yes. How many? In abundance. Yes. And how tough and enemies they were? You will think about Abu Jahl. You cannot find such a guy in the whole world now. Such a tough guy against the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes. Sayyidina Umar, how strong a man he was. Yes. And how rough an enemy he was to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came to the same extent that he was in prayer. And when he was making dua after prayer at night, he said, Allahumma ayyid al-Islam bi ahad al-Umarain. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthen Islam either with Umar ibn al-Khattab, Umar al-Faruq, or Amr ibn Hisham, who is called Abu Jahl. Yes, so he made it dual, or tasniya of Amr and Umar. So he said, bihad al-Umarain, with one Umar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthen Islam. And the next day, when Abu Jahl had summoned the assembly, or the gathering, or in our Afghanistan, we call it Loya Jarga. What we call? Loya Jarga. Here they call it Congress or Senate. Yeah, Congress? Or Senate. And in Israel, they call it what?
Yes.
Knesset. In Russia, they call it?
Duma,
yes. Got it. In India, they call it? Lok Sabha, no?
Lok Sabha.
Lok Sabha. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, that was their Lok Sabha. That was their National Assembly. That was their Duma. That was their Knesset. Or that was their House of Commons or House of Lord. Yes, just name it. So he summoned it. And he said that, you know, that Muhammad has made our life miserable. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To him, according to him, that he is abusing our gods. He is vilifying our gods. He is saying bad things about our... Otherwise, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not saying that. وَلَا تَصُبُّ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ فَيَصُبُّ اللَّهَ عَدْوًا بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you the Muslim, don't go out of limits. Never say bad words against the gods of non-Muslims. Otherwise, in retaliation or reaction, they will say the same bad words about your God. What you will do that? There. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, for example, yeah, Isha prayer, inshallah, 1 o'clock. So my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, if somebody, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive and forbid, he will use a bad word against someone and he retaliated, who is the responsible for that bad word? Say, the one who said the first one. Because the other guy, he showed the reaction. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, Al-mutasabbani ma qalahu fa'ala al-awwali minhuma. What a beautiful hadith, Shaykh Abu Bakr. Al-mutasabbani ma qalahu fa'ala al-awwali minhuma. The two guys who are saying bad or F words to one another, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the basic responsibility or burden is on the shoulder of that one who started it. Yeah, that's a common sense. That's a matter of common sense. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he had the strongest ever common sense. So he said, Al-mutasabbani ma qalahu fa'ala al-awwali minhuma. The two mutasabban from sab who are using bad words. So he said that the big burden is on the shoulder of that one who started it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا تَصُبُّ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ فَيَصُبُّ اللَّهِ عَدْوًا بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. In a hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that very dirty people are those who are doing this, 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 this. وَالَّذِي يَصُبُّ أَبَاهُ. وَالَّذِي يَصُبُّ أَبَاهُ. And the one who is saying bad words to his father. So Sahaba Ridwanullah alayhim ajma'in, they never considered that somebody will say bad word to his father. So they, oh, yasubbu rajul abha. Ya Rasulullah, is there anyone all over the world that he will be saying bad words to his own father? So what the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yasubbu abha rajul fa yasubba abahu. This guy will say bad words to the father of that guy and he will retaliate and say, so actually this guy caused that bad word to his own father. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا تَصُبُّ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ فَيَصُبُّ اللَّهَ عَضًّا بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. Never say bad word against the gods of non-Muslim, otherwise they will say the same or the same like regarding your Allah. Then what you will do? You have caused him to say the same. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he never said bad words against their God. The only thing, he was talking about the subject. He was speaking about the subject. He was saying that أَتَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَنْفَعُكُمْ وَلَا يَزُرُّكُمْ. You are going to worship those who cannot harm you a little nor can give you any benefit. They are neither نَافِعْ nor ضَارْ. وَإِن يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِذُرِّنْ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُ وَإِن يُرِدْكَ بِخَيْرٍ فَلَا رَادَّ لِفَضْلِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if Allah is touching you with some evil or some hardship or some difficulty or some calamity, is there anyone to take it away from you?
No.
Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith narrated by Imam Tirmidhi, لَوْ اجْتَمَعَ النَّاسُ عَلَىٰ أَن يَنْفَعُوكَ بِشَيْءٍ لَمْ يَنْفَعُوكَ إِلَّا بِمَا قَدْ كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَكَ وَلَوْ اجْتَمَعُوا عَلَىٰ أَن يَضُرُّوكَ بِشَيْءٍ لَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ إِلَّا بِمَا قَدْ كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَكَ. That if people from all around the world, they will get together to harm you, Prophet ﷺ said they cannot do it, but only to the extent of what Allah has decreed. And if they will get together to give you some benefit, they cannot do it, but only to the extent of what Allah has decreed already. But our case is that we are becoming too much emotional regarding things. We are trying to get and gain things before it's time. Otherwise, it will never happen. There's a story. Sayyidina Ali, radiallahu ta'ala an, he was riding his horse somewhere in the desert. And that was the time of Zuhr prayer fasting. So Sayyidina Ali was thinking of a tree, if there is any, to tie his horse with and to pray the prayer. But in desert, no tree was there. No shrub was there even. Yes, white sand. So nothing was there. He was thinking of someone. If he will hold my horse, so I will pray my prayer. Nobody was there. Suddenly he saw from far. He said, brother, I'll do it. So he rushed. He said, can you please hold my horse? I want to pray. He said, okay. He held it. Now Ali's prayer was not like our prayer. Yes, right. We are trying how soon to get rid of our prayers. Got it? Their prayer was prayer. So Sayyidina Ali, with due attention, focusing on his prayer, focusing on Allah, أَن تَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ فَإِنْ لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَاهُ فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاكَ. To give you a very simple example, you are driving. Yes or not? You people are driving or not?
Yes.
You are living in America. So everybody is driving here, even 16 years of age, 16 and a half. Yes, legally you can do it. Yes, so you are driving and you are driving on freeways as well. The moment you see the sheriff or the highway patrol, what happened to your speed? Yes, subhanAllah. And the moment you see the sign, you don't see any sheriff or highway patrol. But it is said that the speed is checked by radar or checked by the aircraft. So once again, how focusing you are on your meter. Yeah. Just keep in view that one. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Antahbud Allah ka annaka tara." Worship Allah like as you are looking at Allah and you see Him. فَإِن لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَى فَإِنَّهُ يَرَى. If you cannot focus to such an extent, at least this one that He is watching you. So if we will come to this level, and we will make our mind in such a way that Allah is watching me whatever I am. Look, I heard a tasbih. Yes, you have it as well. I correct muzakkira. What is it? Muzakkira. This tasbih, because we say subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, Allahu akbar. So muzakkira, it reminds you, when you have it in your hand, so for a while you will be doing like this, for nothing, then you will say, Allahumma salli wa sallim ala sayyidina wa rahmatullahi ala sayyidina wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh sallim, la ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimeen, hasbi allahu la ilaha illahu, alayhi tawakkaltu wa rabbul arshil azim. You will say something. You know what I am saying? So, zikr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Quran, time and again, He says, faskuru, faskuru, uskurullah, uskurullah, uskurullah. What it means? Just say subhanallah. Just say alhamdulillah. No, uskurullah means focus on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What it means? Look at me. You are in job. You are in your own business. You are in masjid. You are at home. You are walking on the sidewalk. Or wherever you are, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are taking a step, you are violating His rule. You are doing a business, you are violating His rule. You are performing your duty, you are fulfilling your job. Here we do think, look at me, this is shaitan who is deceiving us. Living here, one guy, he asked me, that Sheikh, this is America. I said, yes, I know that. Yes, I heard a document. I'm not illegal here. So I know this is America. He said that here, certain rules, if he didn't use the word violated. He said certain rules, if not followed, rules of Islam, if not followed, I think it will be okay. I think it will be. I said, why? He said, because this is Dar-e Harb. This what? This is Dar-e Harb. Dar-e Harb means a non-Muslim state. I said that what the concept of Dar-e Harb is specifically. I have written that book, as Sheikh Abdul Basir mentioned, and that is Sharia and politics. So I have written there a chapter. I have written there a chapter that how a state is to be established. And what are the ingredients or contents of state? And how many sorts or kinds of states are there? That what is Dar-e Harb? What is Dar-e Islam? What is Darul Aman? What is Darul Ahad? And what is Darul Sulh? I don't know Libya nowadays. That is Darul Ahad or Darul Sulh or Darul Aman. Nothing is there. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring khair to the whole world. Amen. Say Ameen. Amen. Allah has created this world very beautiful. Is it or not?
Yes.
We the human, we destroyed it. We made it a butchery. We made it a trash. And we would be questioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I had handed it over to you in this shape, what you made. ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر بما كسبت أيدي الناس ليزيقهم بعض الذي عملوا لعلهم يرجعون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, whatever you are doing, you will be facing the after effects. And Allah says, that's also a mercy of mine. I am causing you to taste that after effects so you may make a U-turn. But I think that our sense is gone and live somewhere. Yes, we are not thinking of that. To make a U-turn. You know what I'm saying? Now, you have the navigation system. Yes. What they call it? GPS. You have the GPS. When you miss your exit, GPS calls you. Make a U-turn. It calls you or not? Make a U-turn. Here, I think that our GPS is broken. It is not calling on us that you are going and you have missed your exit. Yes? Or you have missed your route. Just make a U-turn. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر. بما كسبت أيدي الناس ليزيقهم بعض الذي لعلهم يرجعون. To cause them to taste some of the after effects of what they have done. Maybe. Maybe they will make a U-turn. So we say, oh Allah, maybe we are not making a U-turn. because we are stupid, foolish people. So when you will use your sense, and that's what I said, that mostly we the Muslims, and with due apology to Sheikh Abdul Bashir and Sheikh Abu Bakr, and to this brother as well, yes, he is looking like a sheikh, I don't know him, yes. So anyhow, no, look, when you, I don't know you, sorry, yes, but anyhow, when you follow the ways of ulama, you are looking like a ulama. Al-mar'u ma'aman ahabba. In a hadith, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Sayyidina Sauban radiyallahu ta'ala an, who? Sauban radiyallahu ta'ala an, he was sitting there in front of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes, and he was looking at the Prophet like this, and he controlled his eyes, the blink of his eyes even. He was not blinking. Otherwise, this is a natural movement, so you cannot control it. If you have a supernatural power, then you can control it. Otherwise, yes, just do it like this. Yes, after a while, you will not feel it and jump. But Sayyidina Sauban radiallahu ta'ala, he got the power of love with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he was looking at the Prophet like this for a while. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam noticed it. He said, Maraka ya Sauban. Sauban, what's going on? Sauban, what's going on? Ya subhanAllah. These Sahaba were the nice people. After the messengers of Allah, the whole world has not seen a group like that of Sahaba. Rizwanullahi alayhim ajma'in. Every one of them, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, that if they have given in charity a small mud of wheat, that much. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, and you people are spending gold like that of the mountain of Uhud. Ma balagha sa'a ahadihim wa la mudda ahadihim. What the Sahaba, they have done for the deen of Allah, you cannot go close to their status even. So they were the people. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ اخْتَارَهُمْ Ibn Masud says, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ اخْتَارَهُمْ لِصُحْبَةِ نَبِيِّهِ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They were the election or the selection or the choosing of Allah. Allah chose them for the company of His Prophet. So do you think that either Allah made a mistake that he has chosen wrong people for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or Muhammad made a mistake that keeping them as his companion and his friends? The moment I will think about a friend of mine that he's a cheater, he's a liar, I will say bye bye to him. I will become, yes, indifferent of him. Yeah. He's not home. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, so anyhow, Sauban radiallahu ta'ala an, he was looking at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam like this. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Sauban, what's going on? He said, oh, the messenger of Allah. Today I was thinking, تَكُونُ فِي الدَّرَجَاتِ الْعُلَىٰ فِي الْجَنَّةِ Where you will be living in Jannah, subhanallah, how high you will be there, your castle, zone where you are living, the high status, the highest status, the utmost highest status is that of sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So I said that I was thinking that we will not be able to come close to you even there and to see you. So then I thought that whenever you are there and I am sitting in front of you, I don't want to deprive myself of your seeing even to the extent of the blinking of my eye. Even though you cannot feel it. Here your eye is blinking, but you don't feel it that something yes, disappear. Because that's too little. Yes, in a nanosecond or less than that. But he said, at least the reality is, yes, if you will zoom, not the zoom, but if you will zoom the camera on someone and you will hold it, so you will find that at that time, yes. Got it? That or not it? That everything blackened to the blink of the eye. So he said that I was thinking that I should not deprive myself looking at your face even to the extent of the blink of an eye. So Jibreel Amin came and said, وَمَا يُتَعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ. There is a hadith Qudsi. Very detailed hadith. Hadith al-Qudsi. I've written a book in Hadith al-Qudsi, and that is An-Nafakhat al-Unsiyya fil Hadith al-Qudusiyya. النفخات الأنسية في الحديث القدسية. So in a hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that in Jannah, the highest people, they will be in the highest level. Yes, there are great. Yes or not? Here, what is the posh area? The highest area? I don't know. Yes. For example, in our area, we have the, what? The Beverly Hills. Yes. Where Angelina Jolie is living. So anyhow. Yes or not? A lady? Gaga. Yes. Lady Gaga is living here. Yes, Angelina Jolie is living. Because they are making a lot of money. Or the big attorneys and doctors, they are living there. Beverly Hills is known for. So there are elites. They are living in elites area. And there are simple people like us living in apartment and broken room and broken kitchen and broken bathroom and things like that. So anyhow, in Jannah, nothing is broken. But still, the grades are there. Still, the darajat are there. You know what I'm saying? As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, يُقَالُ لِقَارِ الْقُرْآنِ اقْرَى وَرَتِّلْ كَمَا كُنْتَ تُرَتِّلُ فِي الدُّنْيَا فَإِنَّ مَنْزِلَكَ عِنْدَ آخِرِ آيَةٍ قَرَأْتَهَا. Recite and do tartil. Do tartil. Wartaqi. And go up. Climb over. Step by step. With every single ayah, you will be going one step high. And where you will stay? فَإِنَّ مَنْزِلَكَ عِنْدَ آخِرِ آيَةٍ قَرَأْتَهَا. Your room is, or your castle is where you have recited the last ayah you have. Now somebody will be thinking that I have not memorized but only Surah Al-Fatiha and Qul Huwallahu Ahad. Common lay person. So it means that I will be living on the ground or somewhere. Yes, in the annexe. Because I don't have that much. This is not the case. It depends how practical you are. How practical you are. Even though you have 5-10 ayah, but you are practicing accordingly. Yes, so every practice of yours is connected to an ayah of Quran. That's what the Quran say. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, based on your action, he will put a CD or a USB in you and you will recite. And you will go ahead. That's what Hazrat Shaykh al-Hadith Mu'arad al-Qiyas, my murshid. Yes, he has written in the tafsir, in the tashri of hadith, in the explanation of hadith. And some guy who is reciting Quran a lot, that has become his profession. He is earning his bread with. He is leading Taraweeh and getting something. That's good to give something to her. Not some, a lot. Sayyidina Anas radiallahu ta'ala, sometime he used to invite some Qurra to his house. Just read Quran. And he was a rich man. Sayyidina Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala. So he used to give them food and to give them some money. That habit, use it for yourself. You are the Qurra of Quran. But a Qari of Quran should not ask for that. Hal jazaa wal ihsan illa ihsan. People should think of that this Qari came. He led us in Taraweeh. Sheikh Abu Bakr, he is serving us in deen here in this masjid. He is not a snake that he will be eating dust. Yes? And you have to respect your imam. You have to respect your hafiz and your teacher. You have to respect your ulama. You know what I'm saying? Don't put them down. I'm very sorry to say. We are destroying our ibadat. We are thinking of Imam that he's a janitor. He's our servant. We are playing game with him. Everybody is showing muscle to the Imam like he is the boss. Yes. So in our area, we had one Imam. He was very sharp. He was very sharp. So one masjid asked him for Imamat. He went there. So he said that, Sheikh, I gave them a lecture. I said that what? I told them that, look, you brought me here as an imam. They said, yes, of course, and we are thankful to you. He said that, look, in Islam, a woman can have only one husband. A woman. Islam does not allow for a woman at the same time more than one husband. Yes, he said, I'm your imam. And I have a bitter experience. Yes, so make it clear which one is my husband. Yes, so I will be subject to him. Everybody should not dictate me. They say, no, you are our imam. Please, for the sake of Allah, you are our imam. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters, look, to tell you the truth, if I don't have a respect for someone, I don't pray behind him. Because I am presenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala my prayer through him. Yeah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, how can I accept your prayer through that guy for whom you do not have any respect in your eyes? You ask me to respect him for your prayer while you do not have any respect for him. Now as I was referring to a hadith, and that hadith is written right on the top of the mihrab in Masjid Nabawi. Shaykh Abu Bakr, you have performed Umrah? Yes. Hajj? Alhamdulillah. So if you have not noticed, this time when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the opportunity, so the mihrab where the Imam is standing, right over the mihrab, this hadith is written there, and that is narrated by Hafiz ibn Majah rahmatullahi alayh. When I saw it for the first time in 1995, so I said, oh, this hadith I don't memorize where that is. So then I was looking for Sayyidina ibn Majah rahmatullahi alayh. He has written Sunan ibn Majah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِذَا أَرَدْتُمْ أَن يَتَقَبَّلَ اللَّهُ صَلَوَاتِكُمْ فَلْيَأُمُّكُمْ عُلَمَاءُكُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ وَفْدُ اللَّهِ بَيْنَكُمْ وَبَيْنَ رَبِّكُمْ. Shaykh Abu Bakr, you should memorize it. إِذَا أَرَدْتُمْ أَن يَتَقَبَّلَ اللَّهُ صَلَوَاتِكُمْ فَلْيَأُمُّكُمْ عُلَمَاءُكُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ وَفْدُ اللَّهِ بَيْنَكُمْ وَبَيْنَ رَبِّكُمْ. If you want your prayers to get accepted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then the proper ulama should lead you in prayer. Here we are thinking that that is services. Yes, for service. Is there anybody to take us to hell? Yes. Oh brother, think of this is worship. This is ibadah. Yes, we are living here in America, but we should not copy others. We should not copy the Christians as they are thinking of their priests. You must give a due respect to your Imam. If not, I will ask the Imam as well that please tell them, sorry, I cannot do it. Bye-bye. I am no more here. I am not going to destroy my ibadah or your ibadah as well. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِذَا أَرَدْتُمْ أَن يَتَقَبَّلَ اللَّهُ وَيَقْبَلَ اللَّهُ صَلَوَاتِكُمْ فَلْيَأُمُّكُمْ عُلَمَاءُكُمْ. If you want your prayers to be accepted to Allah, so then your ulama should lead you in prayer. فَإِنَّهُمْ وَفْدُ اللَّهِ. What is wafd? Wafd is a delegation. Wafd is what? Delegation. For important thing or important issue. For example, to Afghanistan, or to Palestine, or to Libya, or let's say like this, to Putin. If Trump is sending a delegation to talk to Putin, so there will be the common lay people, or some big shots.
Some big shots.
Why? Because Putin is a big shot. Or if Putin want, so he will send someone from the street here, janitor, just go there and talk to Trump, sir. He will be looking for elites whom he will get impressed with. Yes, whom can talk to him in the proper way. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, وَإِنَّمْ وَفْدُ اللَّهِ. They are your delegates. بَيْنَكُمْ وَبَيْنَ رَبِّكُمْ. They are your delegates between you and between your Lord. So you are putting someone who is humiliated in your eyes to be a delegate between you and between Allah. Either you are upgrading yourself and degrading Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or you are degrading the wasita, or the link in between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why what we are facing, we do not understand what Allah says and what Rasulullah said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are thinking of this deen that this is just a rasam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Sayati ala nasi zaman. Sayati ala nasi zamanun. Deenuhum dananiruhum. Wa qiblatuhum nisa'uhum. La yabqa min al-islam illa rasmu. Wa min al-iman illa ismu. Wa min al-Qur'an illa tilawatuh. Aw kama qala alayhi salatu wa salam. A time is coming on my ummah. Their deen will be dollar and dinar. The way we do believe in dinar, just tell me the truth. I cannot give you a surety in this regard that I do believe in deen more than dollar. I do believe in dollar more than Allah. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, deenuhum dananiruhum. Their deen will be there. Dinar. Back home in Libya sometime back you have a very heavy dinar and you don't have anything. Sorry for that situation. May Allah bring khair to Libya as well. Say Ameen. May Allah bring khair to the entire world, especially to the Muslim world. Because the Muslim world is passing through atrocities. Why? Have we ever thought of that? Why we are facing that? Why we are facing this? Ma asaba min musiba fa bima kasabat aydikum wa ya'fu an kaseer. Whatever calamities are befalling you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says these are the after effects of your own doing. For society, the people have collective responsibility. For communities, the people have collective responsibility. That's not individual responsibility. And they should not throw it like a basketball to one another. He will do that and he will do. In Urdu we say, there are Pakistanis or not? Or Indian? Here? Yes. Only Abdul Rahman is there. Oh, you are? Yes. So those who understand Urdu, even some of Afghanis, like Brother Daljan, you understand?
Yes.
Anybody else? Yes, a lot of, yes, Sheikh Abdul Basir, and so many brothers. So we have, or we had a poet, passed away. So he said, Rabite tod gaye wo sabhi jaate jaate. Rabite tod gaye wo sabhi jaate jaate, warna itna to taalluq ta ke aate jaate. So this share is not meant to me. The next share. He says, ke shakwa ye zulmat shab se to kai behtar tha. Everybody is complaining of darkness. Oh, very dark night. This happened, that happened. Everybody is complaining. What you are doing to take away the darkness? What you are going to arrange for to take away the darkness and to get a light? So he said, shakwa ye shod. Shakwa ye zulmat shab se to kai behtar tha. Apne hisse ki koi shama jalate jaate. That everybody should lamp a small lamp, so if 10 people will come, the light will be that big. If 100 people will let a lamp, yeah. But we are saying, he should let it. Why should I? So nobody is letting it. That's why we are living in darkness. Nobody is thinking of good. And Islam, what is Islam? Islam does not believe in individualism. Islam believes in pluralism. Islam believes in social life. And that's why, look at me, my respected brothers and sisters, whatever I am saying, by God, I am saying it from the bottom of my heart. Allah is my witness. Here, we are trying to copy others. Here, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لَتَتَّبِعُنَّ سَنَنَ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ حَزْوَ النَّعْلِ بِالنَّعْلِ حَتَّى لَوْ دَخَلُوا جُحْرَ زَبِّنْ لَدَخَلْتُمُوهُ. Prophet says, you will become that much taqleedi of others. That much impressed by other nations. لَتَتَّبِعُنَّ سُنَنَ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ. You will follow their footsteps. You will follow their culture. You will follow their habits. سُنَنَ مَنْ كَانَ حَزْبَ النَّعْلِ بِالنَّعْلِ. And you will be trying to be similar to them like the shoe of the same man to the other shoe of the same man. Shape is one. Measurement is one. Yes. Nobody has right foot 7 and left foot 12. Is there any?
No.
Otherwise he will be having a problem. Yes. If 7, so both feet should be 7. If 9, so both. Yeah. And shape, if you will be having one slipper and another one boot. Yes. How good you will be looking when you are walking in the bazaar. Nobody is doing that. So Prophet ﷺ said, what a beautiful example. Yes, this was a man. This was a man, a great man. This was a man. What? A great man. But the greatest man. Anybody can be a man to the extent he is creating similarity with that great man. That's the criteria. The more you have resemblance with that great man, you are a great. Abu Bakr was a great because he was most similar to Prophet ﷺ. Umar was a great because he was most similar. Look, to tell you one thing. Look at me. Abis ibn Rabi'ah. What? Abis ibn Rabi'ah. Sometimes Allah creates. So Abis ibn Rabi'ah was a Palestinian. Sayyidina Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala an. He heard about him that in so many things he has similarity with the Prophet naturally. So he wrote to his governor that there is one man, Abis ibn Rabi'ah. Somebody told me that he has some similarity with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The governor answered to him that yes, almost every week I go to see him, yes, because of my love with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Muawiyah radhiyallahu ta'ala wrote to him that if you can, because I am too much involved, if you can, to bring him with a due respect to Damascus. I want to see him. So the governor, he brought him. And when Sayyidina Muawiyah looked at him, he found the similarity. Naked head and barefooted, he rushed to the guy and he kissed his head. Ya subhanallah, ma hadha shib. They were in love with the Prophet. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Abu Huraira, radiallahu ta'ala. Who?
Abu Huraira.
Say aloud. Abu Huraira, radiallahu ta'ala. In battle of Siffin, unfortunately, that was a battle happened between whom and whom? Say, Sayyidina Ali and Sayyidina Muawiyah, Rizwanullah alayhi wa sallam. Both of them, they are related to the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One is the brother-in-law, the other one is son-in-law. Muawiyah is what?
Brother-in-law.
And Ali?
Son-in-law.
And Ali, he is the inscriber of Wahi. And Muawiyah? He is the inscriber of Wahi as well. Got it? Ali, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that you are a piece of my body. And Muawiyah, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah majaru hadi and mahdiya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make him hadi and mahdi. Make him hadi and mahdi. So Sayyidina Muawiyah, radiyallahu ta'ala an, Abu Huraira was with Ali, are in the army of Ali. But he was here with Ali the whole day. At that time, the war also, or the battle or the combat also had certain rules. They were not violating it. They were doing it, yes, after sunrise by 1 hour, the battle will start. And half an hour before sunset. So then they were roaming around freely. They were not harming each other because rules were there. They were committed to their roles and their principles. Life means what? Principles. If somebody does not have principles, that's not a life. Yeah, donkeys have lives, no principles. The bull and the oxes, the dog, all of them, they have it or not?
Yes.
Say, but when any dog adopt and accept certain rules, so the sneaking dog, what's their price? Sometime, even the police dog, he becomes the sheriff chief in different cities. It does or not? Why? Because it follows the principles. He is following? Say, the rules and the principles. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam. So Sayyidina Abu Huraira, radiallahu ta'ala an, after Maghrib prayer, he was going to the tent of Muawiyah, to the other side, to the tent of Muawiyah. So Muawiyah, radiallahu ta'ala, asked him that, Abu Huraira, you are an ajeeb man. Yes, you are at that time fighting us from that side. For Isha prayer, you come here. He said that, sir, Ali is a good Muslim, a Sahabi of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You are a good Muslim, a Sahabi of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Regarding this battle, my ijtihad is that he is on the right side. You are not that much on right as he is. That's why I am with him the whole day. But he said that this time you come here, why? He said because of two things. He said, what are these two things? He said that there we are eating beans every night. Because Ali radiallahu ta'ala was living very simple life, that there we are eating beans every night or spinach. But here, sometimes there are birds, and sometimes there is roasted goat. Yes, that is one. He said, what's the other? He said that when I look at you, you pray, so I feel the resemblance of your prayer with the prayer of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So I taste it. When you pray, so I taste the taste of the prayer of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that's why I come. He said, the first one, I say it as a joke. But actually the second thing, he brings me here because in prayer, you have so much resemblance with the prayer of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Sauban radiallahu ta'ala an, who? Sauban radiallahu ta'ala an, Jibreel Amin came, وَمَنْ يُتِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءَ وَالصَّالِحِينَ. Whosoever will obey Allah and the Messenger of Allah. So such like people will be in Jannah, ma'an nabiyyin, with the Prophet, was siddiqeen, with people of truth, was shuhada, martyr in the path of Allah, was salihin, and the righteous good people. Wa hasuna ulaika rafiqa, what a best companion these people are. If you will have their company, what a best companion they are. So my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Sauban, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him that, Sauban, he should know. Ibn Umar narrates, radiyallahu ta'ala an, that we were sitting in front of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, faqama fina rajul min al-ansar. So one Ansari sahabi stood up. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
You are not sleeping?
No.
Not sooning?
No.
Everything is okay? Yes. So Ibn Umar says, qama fina rajul min al-ansar. One Ansari sahabi, he stood up. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, matasa'a. When the Qiyamah is coming or going to happen? The end of this world and the establishment of a new one. When it will take place? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he asked him, Ma a'adat talaha? What's your preparation for that day? If somebody is asking about exam, about what? Exam. That when the exam will start, so it means that the guy has preparation, that's why he is asking. A guy who does not know anything like me, so he will never ask of exam. If two other students are talking about exam, so he deaf ears. He doesn't want to listen to it because he does not have anything in his brain. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he asked him, وَمَا أَعْدَدْتَ لَهَا? What's your preparation for that day? That is either a test or the result of test. So a guy who has done his paper very well, that's why he is asking and looking into the computer that if some message has come to me that you passed A+. Yes, and some guy, he has not written anything in his paper. Yes, if somebody else will open the computer, he will not look at it. That I am fail, I know. So Prophet asked him, Mama Adat Talaha, what's your preparation for? So Sahabi was a very nice man. He said, Ma Adat Talaha min kaseer salatin wala sawmin wala sadaqa. Not so many prayers, or so many fasting, or so many charities. Yes, I have one thing. What is that? Illa an yuhibbullah wa rasoolah. I am in love with Allah and with the Messenger of Allah. That's the whole assets I have. The whole stuff I have. My love with Allah and love with... And that is sincere love. Illa an yuhibbullah wa rasoolah. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never posed another question. Yes, he told him, Al-mar'u ma'aman ahabba. When you are in love with Allah, you will be with Allah. When you are in love with Muhammad, you will be in Muhammad. There is no need of asking furthermore. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us that love.
Amen.
So respected brothers and sisters in Islam, anyhow, the point was that what I was referring to.
The four groups.
Yes. فَوَلَيْكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ عَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءَ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا. How you will become one of these group or companion to these group? Nabi, you can never be. Is there any room for any Nabi?
No.
After Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam?
No.
Siddiq? Yes. You will try. You will try. Allama says, or Allama Akbar, rahmatullahi alayhi. What he said? Ke muhabbat mujhe un jawano se hai, sitaron pe jo dalte hai commands. Make your target the highest one, that I will approach that point. Maybe you will never in your lifetime, but you will try. You will try. And if you will make your target this one,
yes,
done. You will never approach this one even. Two step further. So make your target too much high. So you will. And that's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Unzuru fi dunya ila man huwa asfal minkum. Wa fi deen ila man huwa a'la minkum. Wa kama qala alayhi salatu wassalam. Regarding worldly things, worldly belongings, worldly attachment, properties, palazas, bank balance, fleet of cars, things like that. Look at someone who is lower in grade than you. So somebody, he does not have a Toyota Corolla of 1967. Yes? And you have a Toyota Corolla of 1983. Yes? So you should look at that guy that he does not have that one. I have at least this old car of 1983. You will be thankful to Allah. Yes? But our case is that if you have a car of 2016 and you saw someone that he got a 2018 new one. No content in your whole life. No mental peace and mental tranquil in your whole life. You will never be satisfied in your life. You are making your life yourself miserable. What a beautiful... Yes, prescription Prophet gave us. Unzur fi dunya ila man huwa asfar mink. Wa fi deen ila regarding deen. Look at someone who is highest in practice than you. Yet what a man. He is going to masjid 5 times a day when he is home. Yeah. But regarding deen, we are doing the other way around. No, we are praying Juma. And you know the Mr. So-and-so, he is coming sometime for Eid prayer. Okay. So if you are looking at that guy, so you will be saying bye-bye to Juma prayer very soon. Yes, you will follow that guy. That Eid is more than enough. Now, like Ramadan is coming, inshallah. Say, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all of us many, many opportunities. That's a blessing and blessed month. So Ramadan is coming. So for Ramadan, we are very eager. But for what? Number one, for Taraweeh. And number two, for Iftar. Number one, for Taraweeh. And number two, for Iftar. Before Ramadan, you will be saying, maybe Sheikh Abu Bakr has experienced that as well. You will be, what time Taraweeh start? Yes, so I say, brother, Isha prayer starts at such and such time. So he said, what time Taraweeh start? I say, brother, Isha prayer start in such a... He said, no, I want to come for Taraweeh only. I say, brother, don't come for Taraweeh. There is no need of Taraweeh. Because Isha prayer is for us, Taraweeh is Sunnah. Our case is, we are too much eager for Eid prayer rather than a farz prayer. Eid prayer according to Abu Hanifa is wajib, according to Jumhur, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi, Ahmad ibn Hanbal, that sunnah. Yeah. So you are that much eager for sunnah, not for faras. You know what I'm saying? So it means you describe the discipline. You describe. And the sequence. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam. So think of your deen, that this is deen. Number one, this is not a religion. Religion is a set of a few rituals. This is a perfect system. Practices as much as you can. Don't make pick and choose. Do not make it a deen of convenience. Make it a deen of obedience. You will memorize this word of mine. Do not make it a deen of convenience. Deen of obedience. Yes. We have weaknesses. We have shortcomings. We have it or not?
Yeah.
If something you couldn't have done it, so don't make excuses. Just ask for forgiveness. That Allah, I missed it, forgive me. But at that time, yes, we get involved in if and but. What is this? You are contesting a case with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah said it, just have it. You couldn't have done it, say, oh Allah, forgive me. That's my shortcoming. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Malik. He's the king. Say, the king, when you will submit to him, you will lower your head to him, that, oh Allah, I am very much ashamed of the wrong I have done. He's very kareem. Why? That's your case in Jannah. And here, if you will be making these type of excuses, and if and but, you say, okay, guy, But at that time you say, if, and but, which you are contesting a case with me? Be humble, submissive to Allah. That's what Islam means. Islam is total submission to the will of Allah. What is Islam?
Total
submission to the will of Allah. Yes, and with due apology to Sheikh Abu Bakr and Sheikh Abdul Basir. Yes, I did make enter Abdul Rahman as well. He is from Jama'ah. I'm from Jama'ah, but off and on. Yes. I'm neither from Mullah side nor from Jama'ah side. I'm nowhere. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make me a good Muslim along with you.
Amen.
Say Amen.
Amen.
So once I made a joke and I told Abdul Rahman sir, that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all the ulama Muslims. And may Allah make all the tablighis humans. So he was saying that, Sheikh, I didn't understand. So I said that, okay, this need a little bit more explanation. I said that too, look, what Islam mean? No pick and choose. No pick and choose. Total submission to the will of Allah. And that's why Ibrahim and Ismail, they were exemplary Muslims or not?
Yes.
When they built up the house of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the first ever dua they made, Rabbana taqabbal minna, innaka antas sami'ul alim, accepted these efforts of ours. And then they said, Rabbana waj'alna muslimain laka. They were Muslim, but once again, they were making dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make us father and son both good Muslims. There is always room for improvement. Say, in Islam there is improvement. In humanity there is improvement. As I told you, that who is the utmost highest human being? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You have awared that highest point of... You have awared that highest point of humanity? Not yet, you are too down. And you have to approach too. So that's why I said, let me Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the ulama Muslims and the tablighis humans, and make us, all of us humans. Say ameen. That's what I was saying now in Shaykh Abu Bakr, instructor. I was saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He made man. He made man. And He sent all the messengers to make them human. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I made them man. Adam, go. Nuh, go. Ibrahim, go. Musa, go. Isa, go. Muhammad, go. Alayhi salawat wa taslimat. Strive hard. Make them human. Because I have not created Jannah for man. I have created it for human. I have created for human. And that's what our Mawlana Rum says. Rahmatullahi alayhi. Mawlana Jaruddin Rumi. You know him or not?
Yes.
You don't know? Yes. He is as famous now in the Western world as Sheikh Zubair is. Wali Muhammad, Sheikh Zubair. Sometime back, he was the what? The most read poet. Who? Sheikh Zubair, Shakespeare. But now, the most read poet in the West is Mawlana Jaruddin Rumi. He is the Mawlana Jaruddin, yes, Rumi. Because Qawniya at that time was part of Rome. Got it? And his last citizenship, as you are American now, no more Afghan. So his last citizenship was that of Rome. So that's why he's called what? Even though he was born where? In Balkh. Yes? He was born in Balkh. Then he went to Persia, to Iranian. That's why the Iranian claim every great person that he was Iranian. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, they say Mawlana Jaruddin, Irani. And they said Jamaluddin? Say Jamaluddin? Afghani or Irani? They don't admit it that he is Afghani. They say Say Jamaluddin, Irani. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, our shortcoming is like this Shaykh Abu Bakr, that every great person, we do claim him. Rich person, we say our cousin. Everybody says my cousin. He doesn't know him and he says my cousin. Yeah. And a poor guy like me, my own brother is running away from me. I don't know. He is from our village, a little bit far. Oh brother, my father and your father and my mother and your mother are the same, but still you are too far. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, I'm coming back to the ayat I have recited. Otherwise, that will be a discrimination to the ayat of Holy Quran, which I have recited. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاكْتُبْ لَنَا فِي هَذِهِ الدُّنْيَا حَسَنًا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنًا إِنَّا هُدْنَا إِلَيْكَ. The only thing which I was referring to Mawlana Jaruddin Rumi, he says, كَ مِي بِنِي خِلَافِ آدَمَتْ. كَ مِي بِنِي. Who understands Persian?
Yes.
Who else?
Yes.
Yes. كَ مِي بِنِي خِلَافِ آدَمَتْ. Next, Adam dar ghilafe Adamant. He says, those you are looking at, they are not humans. They are not, they have the cover of humans. Next, Adam, they are looking like humans. Inke maybe ni khilafe Adaman. Next, Adam dar ghilafe Adaman. Adamiyat. Adamira Adamiyat lazimast. Adamira. Adam, we say in Pashto, study the study to pakar de. Adami ke liye adamiyat chahiye. You know, for man, manhood is needed. Man is not the name of the structure you have. Manhood is a quality. Manhood is
quality.
Quality. As we say, that he is a man. Oh, brother, if you will check all of them, they are men. But the guy who has the character, so then here in front of all, we say he is a man. Yes? We cannot discover people that look to his men or not. But based on quality, we say he is a man. As an Arab poet said, Shaykh Abu Bakr, Les al Fata, may yakudu kana abi, walakin al Fata, may yakudu ha anaza. That is not a man or a young man who said, my grandfather, he fought Russians. Yeah. Oh, brother, what you did? So the Arab poet said, Les al Fata, may yakudu kana abi. That's not a man who says, my father, my grandfather, my great-grandfather. He has done this, this, this. Who will be looking into history that whether you are telling us the truth or that's a lie? وَلَكِنَّ الْفَتَى مَنْ يَقُولُهَا أَنَزَى. A strong man or a man is that one, that is me, I can do this. So respected brothers and sisters in Islam, وَكْتُبْ لَنَا فِي هَذِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنًا آدَمِيرَ آدَمِيَّتْ لَازِمَسْتِ. He says, man needs manhood. Adamiyat, Oud ra garbu nabashad, has a must. You know Oud? The wood. When you will lit it, so it scents. The perfume scents. Yes or not? If you will lit it and it will not sense, what you will do? You will throw it away there in the trash. So he said that Oud means the quality. So if human does not have that perfume sense, just trash him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala trashed such like humans. To tell you only one example, there was one guy, well-known guy in Makkah, in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Amr ibn Hisham, who was titled as Abu Jahl. Such a handsome man. Yes, sir, from head to toe. What a stature he had. What a complexion he had. What a feature he had. Handsome, number one. Number two, such a strong man. That when he decreed a decree, there was no any other court to go to that court against his decree. Because he was called Abul Hakam, father of judges. He was called what? Father of judges or father of rulers. So nobody had any right to go to any court and to talk about the decree given by Abu Jahl. Number three, he was as rich that you cannot imagine. So there are three things the ulama says. Number one, the Jamal. What? The Jamal. What is Jamal? The beauty. Number two, the Maal. What? The wealth. And number three, the Kamal. Some status you have. That was a status. Yes. No appeal on his decree and decision and judgment. So he had all three. He had all three. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dissected him, so he brought him forth to us in Holy Quran. أُولَٰئِكَ كَلَنْغَامِ بَلْهُمْ أَزَلْ وَأُولَٰئِكَ أُمُرْ غَافِلُونَ. Allah said, to me, Abu Jahl and these people are worse than dog and donkeys. They are worse than pig and porks. Why? Because they did not have the qualities. Hassan al-Basra, Bilal al-Sahab al-Suhayb al-Rum. Shaykh Abdul Basir, what? Hassan al-Basra, Bilal al-Sahab al-Suhayb al-Rum, Zihaki Makkah Abu Jahl Ijib al-Ajabis. Hassan Basri was from Basra. And Basra is Al-Iraq al-Arabi and Al-Iraq al-Farsi. Al-Iraq al-Farsi. Yes, Kufa is the center of Al-Iraq al-Arabi, but Basra is the center of Al-Iraq al-Farsi. So Hassan Basri was from? Iraq al-Farsi. Hassan is Basra. Where from Bilal came? From Abyssinia. From Habsha. Where from? From Habsha. From Hassan is Basra, Bilal as-Habash. Suhaib al-Rum, Suhaib ibn Sinan. Where from he came? From Rome. Yes. But when we say Hassan Basri, so all of us, yes, we bow down like this to his greatness and we say Rahimahullah. Yes, when we say, Asr is narrated by Imam Hassan Basri, Rahmatullahi Alayhi. This hadith is narrated by Imam Hassan Basri. That name is more than enough. We say authentic. We say what? Authentic. But he was from Basra. And Bilal, he was from Abyssinia. He was from Abyssinia. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told him, Bilal, what do you do? On the night of Ascension and Miraj, when I was visiting the model of Jannah, or the Jannah, to revive, the model of Jannah, or the Jannah. So I was hearing this sound of you are walking in front of me. كنت أسمع خفقا عليك أمامي. كنت أسمع خفقا عليك أمامي. You are walking sound like when you walk, the sound that comes around. So I was hearing that, oh, this is Bilal Khafq. And so what do you do? So he said, Ya Rasulullah, I don't know much more. But ما توزعت وضوءا إلا وقد صليت به ركعتين. There are two things are there. Number one, when I go for my natural call, yes, to the bathroom. So I don't come out like this, but I make wudu. Cleanliness is next to godliness. At-tahuru shatru iman. He said that I never did that job, but I clean myself and make wudu. And when I make wudu, so then I pray two rakat to pay thanks to Allah that He empowered me to make wudu. And to be Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fa'alayka bihi. Be committed to that. That is the action. That was the amal who took you in front of me to the Jannah. And then Bilal, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, whom used to be put on the burning coal and the burning type of sand in Makkah, a big rock on his chest, choked by his master, Umayyah ibn Khalaf al-Khabis. Yes. Dragging him from his legs in the stony and rocky streets of Makkah. His body was bleeding. His skin was ripping out. Dead Bilal, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Sayyidina Umar, what a great man he is. The history can bring another example of Umar?
No.
Say?
No.
No. As I mentioned time and again, that such a great man, that a Britisher, he wrote a book on his biography. Biography of who? Hazrat Umar, radiyallahu ta'ala. In the preface, he has written that the Muslim Ummah has not provided a second Umar. Otherwise, there would not have been any kafir all over the world. The system he presented. Now, I was referring to that Scandinavian countries, you have the welfare system here. That's enough. Social welfare.
Yes?
Yes. What they say? Security.
Social
security system or whatever. Yes. So you are taking help from the government. You will need food stamps, this and that. You know what I'm saying? So this system was introduced by Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala in human history for the first time. In his time. And that's why Scandinavian countries still, they call it in their laws, Umar laws. According to Umar laws. What do they call it?
Umar
laws. Because that was introduced and established by whom? By Umar radiallahu ta'ala. So that Umar, whom from? The Caesar was shivering because of fear. Not from him even, his generals. Sayyidina Khalid ibn Walid, radiyallahu ta'ala. You study the history or not? We don't study neither Quran nor Hadith. We don't have time to go to ulama and to sit in front of them. And I'm sorry to say, the ulama do not have time to sit somewhere and to teach people. Because you and us, equally, we are involved in looking for
dollars.
Because dollar works. Respected brothers and sisters, so Sayyidina Khalid ibn Walid radiallahu ta'ala, he was the leading general in the Battle of Yarmouk. Battle of
Yarmouk.
When they went there, on the other side, the Roman army, the Caesar army. So their general wrote a letter to Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala and sent a delegate to Sayyidina Khalid ibn Walid radiallahu ta'ala and sent a delegation. They came all the way to their tents. This is a letter from our general. So that was written from general so and so. To so and so are the general of the Arab army. They used to call them not the Muslim army. What they call?
Arab.
The Arab army. General of the Arab army. It was written there that we know what has brought you here. Poverty, starvation, destitution. That you are here to fight us to grab some ghanima, spoils of war. So it means that the poverty, destitution, starvation has brought you here. And we know that you are downtrodden people. You need it. So there is no need of fight. There is no need of fight. We will provide to every soldier 3 beautiful dresses and 10 dinars. Dinar was made of gold. 10 dinar and 3 beautiful dresses. And to their general, we will provide a ride as well. At that time, the Birzon, nowadays, the Mercedes or BMW. Sheikh Abubakar, what do you have? BMW? Toyota Corolla? Yes. No, that's actually the third world best car is Toyota Corolla. And we love it. I have Toyota. I think that most of us, we have Toyota. So anyhow, it's taking care is very easy. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters, once again, our foolishness is like this, that if I will sit in BMW, I will be looking a big man. I'll be looking. If I will sit somewhere and I told them that big people, they are living in small houses. And small people, they live in big houses. Big people, they live in small houses. And small people?
Big
houses. Why? They live in big houses.
They want to look big.
So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, the delegation came. Sayyidina Khalid Wali radiallahu ta'ala, he read the letter. So he told the delegation that I think that your general is a very foolish man. So he wrote a letter. Take it to your general that we are in love of drinking blood. And we heard that you, the Roman people, are too much pretty and too much beautiful, having red and white complexion. And we heard that your blood is very tasty and very delicious. They said, what is this? So now the delegation chief, he said to Khalid Walid radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that you know, general, fight is not good for you people. He said, how? He said, look, we have the swords. He said, we have the swords as well. So he said, but our swords, we have done its ishrab with the deadly poison. What is ishrab? When you put the iron in the fire, it become like fire and you will put it in the water. That amal is called ishrab. Yeah, literal meaning is giving it water. So we have given to our swords the poisonous water. So cut is not needed, only scratch is needed. If it will cause you a scratch, even nobody is coming back to life. You know what I mean? So it means that we don't need much more fight, only scratch, 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 scratch. So Sayyidina Khalid radiallahu ta'ala said, what type of poison that is? So one guy from his bag, he brought out a bottle. That this is a sample of that poison. Sayyidina Khalid radiallahu ta'ala said, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Bismillah alladhi adhum wasmi shaykh wa'ala fissamah as-salamu alim. Sahabi said that I was looking at Khalid Walid radiallahu ta'ala, the only thing he did like this. He said, okay, we drink that poison. So the people went back and they said to general, they are not human, they are jinn. They are demons. If they will come to the battlefield, they will eat us. Because that poison, the full bottle, he drank it and nothing happened to him. When he came back, Sayyidina Umar asked him that, Khalid, what you did? He said nothing. Prophet ﷺ once told us that anything harmful, just say Bismillah allazi la yadurru ma ismihi shay'un wa la yasma'u as-sami'u al-'alim. In the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that nothing, yes, can harm you when you mention his name, neither on earth nor in the heaven, and he is the all hearer and all knower. But this is a matter of faith and belief. So anyhow, waktub lana fi hazi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decree in our favor and write it down. Because when you are going to confirm something, you say, give me in written. Yes? So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself, he mentioned, waktub lana, that those who have a strong belief in me, they should ask me that, write it down. waktub lana fi hazi dunya hasana. Give us a good one in this world and in the hereafter as well. Because we are not looking for a good one in the hereafter only. We are looking for a good one here in this world as well. If the Muslims, they do not have the power, they do not have the wealth, they do not have the skill, have the knowledge, they do not have the science and technology, what will be happening to them? Slavery. People say, Abraham Lincoln, he vanished and finished the slavery. Where from? From America, the physical slavery. But slavery of several kinds still exists all over the world. It exists or not?
Yes.
Say.
Yes.
So the poor country, they are slaves or not?
Yes.
Yeah. Those who do not have the science and technology, they are slaves or not?
Yes.
So Imam Waliullah Rahmatullahi Alayh, he has mentioned in his book Hujjatullah al-Baligha that Muslims are bound in the light of Quran and Sunnah to have irtifaq and iqtirab. What is irtifaq? Making their life in this world a strong one. And what is iqtirab? Making their life in the hereafter the best one.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why we are making dua, Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana. Oh Allah, give us a good one here and also a good one.
Yeah.
If you are not a good one here, you have, do not have a good one here, you will be living like a slave. And if you will not have a good one in the hereafter, you will go to the hellfire. So you want to be slave here?
No.
Say,
no.
You want to be in the hellfire in the hereafter?
No.
No, we don't. So that's why, وَاكْتُبْ لَنَا فِي هَذِهِ الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً. O Allah, inscribe for us a good life in this world and a good one in the hereafter. Why? We do admit, we have not done a lot. But إِنَّا هُدْنَا إِلَيْكَ. We have got our boarding pass. إِنَّا هُدْنَا إِلَيْكَ mean we have got our boarding pass. So what boarding pass mean? Now you will go to the flight. What the flight will do? It will take off. What the take off? Will be flying. Then what? San Francisco. For example. Yeah, that we have taken the boarding pass. What is the boarding pass? Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Waktub lana fi hadhihi dunya hasana wa fil akhirah inna hudna ilayka. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, azabi usibu bihi man asha. My punishment or torment, I will cause it to people whom I will. Whom?
I
will. And that is an issue disputed between us, the Ahlul Sunnah, and between Mu'tazila. Mu'tazila, they are of the view that there is no forgiveness without Tawbah. For sins, there is no forgiveness?
Without
repentance. But we, the Ahlul Sunnah, says, depend. You cannot make Allah bound for certain rules. If you say that he is not going to forgive or he cannot forgive, ma'az Allah, any sin of anybody without his repentance and his tawbah, so it means that you are limitizing the entity and the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here he has not put the condition of tawbah. He said, whom I will, yes. So I forgive. Azabi usibu bi man asha, whom I will, so I will punish him. Azabi usibu bi man asha, wa rahmati wasi'at kull shay. But my rahma and mercy includes everything. Wasi'at kulla shay. Wa rahmati wasi'at kulla shay. Fasa'aktubuha lillazina yattaqoon. I will write it down for those who have my fear, who are law-abiding Muslims. Fasa'aktubuha lillazina yattaqoon. Wa yutuna zakah. And they are giving zakat. Wallazina hum bi ayatina yuqinoon. And they have a strong belief in our ayat and our rules. Who are they? Allazina yattabi'una ar-rasul an-nabi. They are those who imitate the messenger, the prophet. Yattabi'un. There is a big difference between two words in Holy Quran. One is ita'a, the second one is ittiba'a. One is ita'a, the second one is ittiba'a. Ita'a means obedience, and ittiba'a means imitation. Ita'a is regarding awamir and nawahi. Restrictions, the Prophet ﷺ has put. Order and commandments, he has given. If you will follow his order and commandment, and you will abstain from what he has forbidden, that is called ita'at. By doing so, you will get into Jannah. You will get into what? Say, in Jannah. But ittiba', that is not his order, nor his prohibition. That is his actions in normal life as a human. That's his action. Huh? See? In normal life, how he was eating, how he was drinking, how he was sitting, how he was talking, how he was dealing the things. Got it? Got it? So this is called imitation. And that's what the Sahaba were doing. Sahaba didn't know that what is farz, what is wajib, what is sunnah. But because usul al-fiqh at that time was not written. Was it? No. So they were not aware of that this is farz, this is wajib, this is sunnah, this is nafal or this is mustahab. The only criterion for them is that what the Prophet did. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they started it. That what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not doing. So they stopped from it. And that is deen. That's called imitation. Sayyidina Salman al-Farsi, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. You know him. You know him or not?
Yes.
All of you. Yes, a great sahabi. A great sahabi. Someone who is not even a Arab. He's a Persian. He's from Persia. Salman al-Farisi, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. But he is the only one. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him not the citizenship, the family ship. He gave him what? The family ship in Battle of Ahzab. When they got victory in the Battle of Ahzab, based on the suggestion given by Salman al-Farisi, so the Ansar became happy. And they said, Salman minna. As I told you, our cousin. But that was not regarding wealth or dunya. That was regarding deen. So they were proud of, because Salman was living in Medina before Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But he came all the way where from?
Persia.
From Persia. So that's why the Ansar said, Salman minna. He's from Ansar. But he was not the local native inhabitant of Medina. He was migrated there. So the Muhajiri said, Salman minna. He's a Muhajir. Yes. He's from our group. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he heard these both shouts. So he got hold of the hands of Salman and he said, Salman minna Ahlul Bayt. Salman minna Ahlul Bayt. He's my family member. He's from us. He's my family member. If you go to Iraq, very close to River Dijla, Tigris River, there is a city known by the name of Madian. Madain. What? Madain. In Madain, the intersection. What? The intersection. You will go there, there is a big mosque on the intersection. And that mosque is named as Masjid Salman al-Farisi. Mosque is named as? Inside the masjid, there is the grave of Salman al-Farisi, radiallahu ta'ala. On the main entrance of the masjid, this hadith is written, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سلمان منا أهل البيت. Salman minna. So that Salman, when he conquered that area, Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas was his big general. He was assistant to him. But Sa'd ibn Waqqas, he was suffering from fever. Yes, he was too much in difficulty. The area chief invited the generals for a dinner. The Iranian. The area conquered. Yes. So the big shots, they are with whom? Nahnu ma'amal ghalab. Who will overtake? The big shots are with them. Yeah. Because the big shots in any area, they do not have any ideology. Do they have ideology? Say. No. They follow what? How to sell their property. Huh?
They worship the rising sun.
That's good. The rising sun. So now the big shot. He invited the generals for a dinner. So Sa'd ibn Waqqas radiallahu ta'ala told Salman Farsi radiallahu ta'ala, Salman, you know that I cannot. Because I'm not, but this is not looking good. Akhlaqiyat is akhlaqiyat. Character is? Character. So you will go. He said, okay, sir. He went. The Iranian carpet is famous all over the world. Carpets are there. Lot of delicious foods, different types. And, yeah, dishes and this and that. Salman Farsi radiallahu ta'ala, he went there and he said, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. He started. One piece of food fell down on the carpet or on the ma'ida. The dastarkhan. We call it dastarkhan. Arab call it? Ma'idah. Yes?
Sofra.
The fabric or sofra, yes. The Arab call it sofra. Yes. So the sofra. The Turkish also call it sofra. I don't know sofra, what came from Turk to Arab or from Arab to Turk. I never made it clear. But both of them, they call it sofra. So on sofra, Salman Farsi رضي الله تعالى, he picked it up and he said, looked at it, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Now, one servant who was fanning them with hand fan, with panka. So he was a Muslim. Yes. So he came close to Salman. Lawma fa'alti ya general. Saratul general, I wish you would not have done it. I wish. Because in Iranian culture, it was not looking good, the fallen piece of food, to take it back and put it in your mouth. So he said, because they were very much impressed by these conqueror generals. But now Salman, when he did that, so what they will be thinking about these generals? So he said, I wish if you have not lifted it up. Yes. لأنهم لا يحسنون. لا يحسنون. Because they don't like it good. The Iranian culture does not like to it as good. So Salman, he was saying slowly. What Salman said, Ya Subhanallah, what a man. He said, هَكَذَا رَأَيْتُ حِبِّي رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَوَ أَتْرُكُ سُنَّةَ حَبِيبِي لِهَا وَلَا يَلْحُمَقَى. He said, هَكَذَا رَأَيْتُ حِبِّي رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. In the same way, in the same practice, I have seen my beloved Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. He did the same. I followed his sunnah. Should I leave his sunnah because of foolish people? Because of foolish people, should I say bye-bye? And yeah, so how much we are impressed with sunnah and how much we are impressed with the culture of others. Got it? So, فَسَعَدْتُبُ وَلِلَّذِينَ الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الرَّسُولَ النَّبِيَ الْأُمِّيَ الَّذِي يَجِدُونَهُ مَكْتُوبًا عِنْدَهُ فِي التَّوْرَاتِ وَالْإِنْجِيلِ. He is written there in Taurat and in Injil both. يَأْمُرُهُمْ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. He is ordering them to do good. وَيَنْهَاهُمْ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ and to abstain from bad. وَيُحِلُّ لَهُمُ الطَّيِّبَاتِ, making طيبات lawful for them, pure things lawful for them. وَيُحَرِّمُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْخَبَائِسِ. Whatsoever is dirty and filthy, he said that is not. Filthy things must be avoided. وَيُحَرِّمُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْخَبَائِسِ وَيَضَعُ عَنْهُمْ إِصْرَهُمْ. إِصْر is something you cannot afford it. A big burden. What? A big burden. Because الْأَمْرُ إِذَا ضَاقَ اتَّسَعَ. This is farz to perform your prayer in standing form. But if somebody cannot stand, what he will do? He will sit. Yeah, it is must for you to do fasting in the month of Ramadan. If somebody cannot do, he will make qaza later on. You know what I'm saying? Al-amru iza daqa ittasa'a. When the situation is tight, the rules are relaxed. This is a general rule. Al-qawaid al-faqhiyya. Al-qawaid? Al-faqhiyya. So in al-qawaid al-faqhiyya, I have written a book on qawaid al-faqhiyya. So there, I have mentioned that this rule has been given by Imam Shafi, rahmatullahi alayhi. Al-amru iza daqa ittasa'a. Situation is tight, rules got relaxed. Got it? So yazaw anhum israhum. وَالْأَغْلَالَ الَّتِي كَانَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ. Fetters of slavery, because there is no slavery in Islam. Islam does not allow nor encourage any slavery. What was happening before? Because that was a culture of that time. Islam was unable to drop it one-sided, because it was not making sense that you will enslave my prisoner and I will release yours. Does it make sense? So that was the culture of Byzantine Empire. That was the culture of Persian Empire. That was going on in every civilization. So Islam kept it, but it encouraged it to free the slaves, not to enslave the free people. Prophet ﷺ says, whosoever will set a slave free, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will set his self free from the hellfire. Got it? وَيَذَوْ عَنْهُمْ إِسْرَهُمْ وَلَغْلَالَ الَّتِي كَانَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ فَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِهِ. So then those who believed in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وعزروه. What is ta'zir? هو التعظيم. وعظموه. What is ta'zim of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? To magnify his personality. Yes, this is a matter of belief. If you will think even of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that somebody in the past history or came here in status in Muhammad, you lost your iman. Your iman is gone, because that's against the word وعزروه. What? وعزروه. Who is the utmost highest personality in the creature of Allah? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِهِ وَعَزَّرُوهُ. Number two. And number three. وَنَصَرُوهُ. And he helped him. He is not here to help him. Mean his deen. Mean his practice. Mean his sunnah. Mean his sharia. In any possible way to help it. ونصروه واتبعوا النور الذي انزل معه. And they follow that light of wahi. This nur is not only Quran, because not only Quran is revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where from his hadith and sunnah came. It's also a revelation. وما ينطقوا عن الهوى ان هو الا وحي يوحى. That's a wahi. So عزروه ونصروه واتبعوا النور الذي انزل معه. Allah says أولئك هم المفلحون. Such like people are the successful people. And then Allah ordered the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, tell them, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Ya ayyuhan nas, O mankind in general. O mankind in general. Inni rasulullah ilaykum jamia. I am not the messenger of Allah for Arabs, for Ajam, for Al Jazeera, for Asia, for Africa, for human in general until the day of judgment. Inni rasulullah ilaykum jamia. Allazi khalaqa as-samawati wal ardh. Who has created this whole world? Why it is mentioned here? الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُو. That one who created the heaven and the earth. He is the creator of the heaven and the earth. And I am the messenger of the whole creature. I am the messenger of the heaven and the earth. Yes or not?
Yes.
الَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُو يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتِ فَآمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ. Believe in Allah. وَرَسُولِ in His messenger. النبي الأمي, the Nabi and the illiterate one. Has he ever gone to any school?
No.
Say.
No.
No. Has he ever gone to any university?
No.
To any madrasa?
No.
Has he ever saw any teacher?
No.
Teaching him Alibba Thasa or ABC? Al-Ummi, Al-Ladhi, Fa'aminu Billah, Wa Rasoolihi Al-Nabi Al-Ummi Al-Ladhi, Yu'minu Billahi Wa Kalimatihi. That Nabi who believe in the ayat of Allah, and he believe in the words of Allah. He believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَحْتَدُونَ. If you will do this, you are the guided people. You are. وَمِنْ قَوْمِ مُوسَىٰ أُمَّةٌ يَهَدُونَ بِالْحَقِّ وَبِهِ يَعْدِلُونَ. Allah says, all Jews, they are not bad. There are good people amongst you. They believe in Muhammad. Salman Farsi, he was a Jew. Salman Farsi, he was a Jew. Abdullah ibn Salam, a great Sahabi, he was a Jew. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مِنْ قَوْمِ مُوسَىٰ أُمَّةٌ يَهَدُونَ بِالْحَقِّ وَبِهِ يَا. We are not anti-Semitic, but we are Semitic as well. Yeah, Sam was not their father only. Sam was our father as well. Arab are also Semitic. Are they or not? Say,
yes.
They are Semitic. So when people say, when we say something about the atrocities by the hands of Jew, Christian, Muslim or whatever, because as you know, that bad things has no religion. Bad thing has no culture. Bad thing has no nationality and no identity. Bad thing is for bad people. That is coming from the Christians or from the Jew or from the Muslim or from the Sikh or from the Hindu or from black or from white and from brown and from gray and from tall and short and west and east. Whatever. Bad is bad and good is good. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillah rabbil alamin.